What's good, y'all? It's your boy NicoThaGreat. We on the first ever episode of Carpool Karaoke, y'all.
I can't explain how honored I feel.
I ain't even got to introduce him. I'm gonna let everybody in the whip. Y'all know who I'm riding with, man.
I feel so tremendous.
Man, let the people know who y'all are, bro.
This man humbling. Tommo, T-O-M-M-O, boy guy. I got Mr. Fuck You Talking About in the background.
Come back!
Jay, on the beat. We gonna do this freestyle for this first episode of this car ride.
Look, mixing it, y'all. Y'all ain't know I was coming with. I told y'all, I'm bringing some shit.
Let him know.
We going crazy. We got the mics. How you feel with the mic, man?
Dog, this mic is the shit. Like, dog.
This is crazy, dog.
It's
lit, bro.
He came to me, he said, look, you want to do the karaoke? I said, oh, I got to. Like, I will gladly be the first episode. I said, I'm going to do something crazy. So that anybody after me got to do something crazy. I brought Mr. Fuck You Talking About. We're going to make the beat in the car. And then I'm gonna rap. Now
he's
gonna
go crazy, bro. And when he go crazy, I don't know what to tell y'all niggas,
man. Rap.
Y'all gonna see when y'all see these mics come back. Just know it's time. It's time.
I'm a real rapper.
When these mics come back, it's fucking time.
I didn't want it more, they need it. Them freestyles banging, what's popping, staying on repeated. And toxic baby daddy on the beat, how you mistreated. And now they want the hugs, but that love I don't believe it. The faking and the hating, you can keep it more. They need it. Them freestyles banging, what's popping, staying on repeated. And toxic baby daddy on the beat, how you mistreated. And now they want the hugs, but that love I don't believe it. The faking and the hating.
You a rapper, you out here, you a lyricist, you a bar guy. As you got, I told him he bar guy, Junior. I'm the real bar guy. One day I'm gonna drop some lyrics on these niggas.
I really want to hear Nico rap.
You gotta catch me when I get the Henny in the system. You like, damn nigga, you need to get signed. I'm chilling. So look, man, you know. You deep in the rap game. I'm gonna fucking with your lyrics and stuff. So
thank you.
Who you feel out here is really making moves? I'll go top three. Just really making moves. And cause me one I feel is just, I think just automatic. And I think it's more so not because of what he put out. It's just how hard shit hit when it drops. It's Drizzy. Now I fucks with Drake. Do I think everything he put out should go automatic one?
So here's my thing with Drake.
Okay.
My favorite Drake album is Thank Me Later. And it was just so, it was kind of original. It was really him. Like, I love Comeback Season. Like, I'm like a mixtape Drake fan. And it's not to say I don't like his new music like that. But it's just, that just shit, it hit me a lot harder when it came out. I think Drake is hard as far as making a bop. He's an amazing artist. That man worked hard. Like, hard. He study algorithms. He makes sure he know what's going on and what's popping. So Drake does a lot to be the artist that he is.
Okay.
As far as like me thinking about amazing lyricists right now or just artists like that, I would have to say West Side Boogie.
I gotta tap into dude. I've been seeing you talking a lot about him since that freestyle you dropped.
Boogie be dropping. Boogie freestyles cold. Everything he spit, the way he mold words, dog. I think it's crazy. Him, Reza, he's a newer artist on TDE.
Okay.
I first heard of him on when Dreamville put out that compilation album with everybody, and Reza was on there. His last project, New Beginnings, crazy. And a third artist, I think that this is somebody I don't even know per se if I would say, but I want to say them because I don't know if they per se get enough respect. With having great lyrics, they're real soulful and they can sing, but they be spitting. Smino got some lyrics.
Hey, bro, Smino's my favorite artist right now, bro. And if you looked at my, people thought I was tripping. If you looked at when I put the recap for the year, I had 92 hours of Smino.
Smino got some, like, bro, he bend bars, he bend the words.
Bro, he got his wordplay is different.
It's different, and I think that deserves a lot of respect. A lot of the other things he do, the melodic way that he rap, cold too, don't get me wrong. But we are not highlighting enough some of the shit he says.
Cause I go back, like I got a whole playlist called the Smino Tapes. Mm-hmm. I just put all the music he dropped, anything he on, I put it on there. I done probably damn near listen to every song, bro, that I've been a part of that I done found on Apple Music.
I need to go and listen to all the way that mixtape he put out.
She only decided. Yeah, she already decided. Bro, I'm gonna send you my.
I got one song on there. It's the song with like him and Seven Streeter. It's in my stroke list.
That shit is my shit. That's my shit. I had to put that in the stroke list. That is my shit. That's on my skate slow list. Boy, I fucked that up. Sweet, then words. No, bro. And I don't want to mess up his lines right now. I'll start quoting some shit. His whole, that whole mixtape, bro. When I listened through, I was just like, this nigga is different. He different. Like, it's too many people be like, oh yeah, no, I'm different. I'm like, no, bro, you really not. That nigga is different.
I think this Mino has so many abilities that I would love to see. Like, I would love to see him go with, like, be on a song with Boogie. And Boogie has, like, a melodic thing to him, too. But not, probably maybe not as hefty as Smee does. I would, actually, and we've seen it, even, like, on the Dreamville tape. He was on that song with Cole and Earth Gang and them.
He was
standing straight next to Cole.
He don't miss. I ain't never heard the nigga put out bad bars.
I ain't never seen
like,
a nigga miss.
You be thinking like, after a while, you'll think, okay, a nigga gonna have to put out some type of trash verse. Mm-hmm. It's like, damn, bro, this nigga just keep going.
I've heard Smee songs that I was like, I'm not as a fan of as some other songs. But,
same here, but they weren't trash.
But they weren't trash.
It's just like, okay, nigga, this is a bottom tier song for you, which is still high tier for another nigga. And yeah, I'm up, bro. You gotta listen to that whole mixtape.
I got it.
Like, when you listen to it straight through, you gonna hear it. Especially when my nigga did the sample of Project Pat Chickenhead. The song called Popeyes.
I ain't heard that one.
I'm gonna have to.
I got to. Crazy, I love bars.
From the first song. And the sample on the first song with the Osley Brothers.
I heard that one. I like that one.
The second one, bro, all the way eight.
Ain't none of them. It's just something about the way, like, good bars and, like, you so crafty. We'll go ahead. Yeah, bro, yeah, look, I'm finna let my dog cook it up. He finna put it in the pot. Man, just whip the beat up. The whole ride, y'all. You feel me? Nah, raindrop April 30th. In the meantime, shout out to Mr. Fuck You Talking About. In the background, yo. I'm the shit now, these niggas can smell me. Top floor, penthouse shades, the view is wealthy. A room full of bad bitches begging for selfies. They say not sleeping for my dream, kinda unhealthy. But they can't see these nightmares on my back, trying to stress me. Be warm, you can push up, but you'll never flex me. Firearms, know what I'm fantastic for? Can't stress me. Erase what I write and feel like a lefty. I can only step now if I come correctly. Team got me. If I fuck up, God correct me. Tell them not to love. We can bubble up, but never test me. It's for the ones who just act all right. Stay smiling like bad bitches. Act all fine. The ones who get passed on, but in fact y'all dimes. Birds and sun. Don't let a hater stop your shine. They got a gimmick. Got the chicken. Now they rock the bling. I tell them like Drake. They got hotlines on, but it's just not their thing. J. Jordan Rad. Retro Nando for the beef. They my five guys. Quit my job. Then I went. Started a label. They talking smack now. We a smack down. And break the tables. Bar God. Ain't no Bible stories. Tired of the fables. Can't kill him. Why? He can't die. Somebody tell him I'm Kane. And bro, you able. Big gun. Showtime. X-Men. No cable. I don't need the team. Less is more. Tell them how I'll never fall. Fuck your letters. We all steppers. I promise if it's done, we're strong, man. No more high routes. Cats in the box. Go low, man. Street sweepers. Mop shit. Leave them like flow stains. Pop shit. Show a hot head to a cold grave. Ice them on tracks. I can't stop. Now that's a cold train. Snoop Dogg. Smoke them in air. Nico, the soul plane. It's off the top like an attic. It's in my blood like a dope vein. And it's gonna hurt when they feel this fire, nigga. I'm propane.
Woo! Y'all heard my nigga go crazy, man.
Hey, they not spit so nasty. You wanna be on Ethnic Ish N More? You assy. Don't ask me.
I might have told this story last time I was on Ethnic Ish N More. One of my friends made one of them posts that was like, I want to start a Zodiac group chat. Two of every sign. Whatever.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, I hopped on it like, I ain't got nothing better to do. That little group chat side talk. Nigga, we got so fucking close in this group chat, dog. Like, the first one that we made, we was missing a couple signs originally, and some extra signs got added. Like Sean just got added because, you know, we were about to do it like everybody knew. But like we became stupid close, and that's where I met Ricky, the girl who's Victoria's song, what that song is about.
My dog.
I probably knew Ricky all of maybe 5 months, 5-6 months. But her passing, that nigga, that shit hurt. Nigga, we cried. I cried watching the video when Sean made it.
Yeah, I remember you was telling me about that.
Nigga, Sean put so much work into that video. And what's funny is, I wrote the song. He heard me write the first verse and the hook. So he kind of like, you know, we said we was going to record it and everything. But he didn't hear me write the second verse. So when we got to the thing and I was like, all right, you know, I've been deciding if I'm going to do this moment of silence or the second verse. He was like, second verse?
I ain't done nothing about no second verse. You want to keep recording?
Yeah, keep recording. And I was just, God, please, let me get some visiting hours. I just really need to bring you these flowers. My mama said ain't no voice for the dearly departed. Hope she still got a sight so she can see where my heart is. We drove all the way. All right, now you get the backstory. After she passed and like everything went down, you know, we figured out her people are like from Indianapolis. We took 3 cars to go all the way to Indianapolis for our funeral. Time is a motherfucker. Like you think that you don't have a lot of time to do stuff, but like relationships can form so quickly.
Small amount of time. Don't take that much time.
It formed, that the relationship formed so literally quickly. Within like a month.
Yeah. A true bond, you can tell when people genuine, when people are true, when people are real. It doesn't take that long to connect to somebody. That's why you be seeing people that get married in 2-3 weeks. Because like, bro, it didn't take them that long to realize like, hey, you love this motherfucker.
She was so fucking funny, dog. Like, she used to say random wild shit. She would throw jokes. She wasn't scared to throw no jokes. It's funny, dog. She could sing. She was a great singer. And when we were like, we do like stupid studio sessions like all the time. She come in and start singing some crazy shit. And like we just clowned all the time. And it just
a very loving soul.
Facts. She was super nice. Like she wasn't mean. Like she definitely wasn't going out of her way to hurt nobody. She might go out of her way to help you. Like,
but that said a lot about the person she was. If y'all have this outlook on her in 5 months,
you know, facts. You know? Like, and that's why like friendships. Like, I've realized like my closest group. Like, your groups change. And, like that. You know, stuff happens. People grow up. It's not always a bad thing. Whatever. But like my group that I see regularly now, Mando, Retro, Jay, Rav has always been around. Sean, Zane, like everybody who be at the crib, like them my dogs. Like we talk about beat niggas. Like I hate to have to kill a nigga for you.
Look,
I hate it had to be this nigga. But if it gotta be that nigga,
hey,
what is it? I hate to tell you, but I do. I shoot him.
I feel that though. I got some homeboys that it wouldn't be shit.
Like
it wouldn't be shit to go there.
What's funny is like, we'll talk and do a whole bunch of other rah-rah kind of shit, like, on the way to do it. Like, God damn, nigga, why we here? We gonna do it, but, like, God damn.
Fuck it.
We here now, you know.
Get your ass off this shit. Niggas coming through with the motherfucking bars. Y'all heard my dog. Tommo, the bar guy.
I'm out.
My man's took the beat up. The whole goddamn ride.
What the fuck you talking about?
We doing this thing for, look, carpool karaoke. Make sure y'all tap in, tune in with us, and we're gonna be doing our thing, man. It's a new series, baby. NicoThaGreat, Ethnic Ish N More, and we out this thing.